As you watch this ridiculous interview, note that MSNBC host Chuck Todd never reminds former Secretary of Defense Leon Panetta or the viewers at home of the sightings reported back in the early 1950s. The reports from astronaut Gordon Cooper and Navy pilot Commander Graham Bethune are ignored. There is no review of the 30,000 feet of UAP film captured by Dorothy Izatt beginning in the mid-1970s. Todd never mentions the outrageous movement characteristics of the targets, either from the 1950s or from the recent Navy carrier encounters.
I got to ask you about UFOs. It is, the truth is out there. The question I have is, we've been reading a lot about a lot of these, that it's mostly been observations of from Navy personnel. Look, Occam's razor this for me. When you've seen this unidentifiable stuff, is your presumption that it is a China or a Russia testing some crazy technology that we somehow don't have, or are we sort of over assuming the abilities of China and Russia, and that the only other explanation is, if it is not us ourselves, that it's something otherworldly?
Well, Chuck, it's obviously been going on for a long time, and there's a lot of speculation. I've never seen any evidence that any of this is related to extraterrestrial human beings or beings of any kind. And for that reason, I've always thought that even though we have these sightings, and I guess the report that's coming out is going to basically acknowledge that there are a lot of sightings. They haven't tied it to being UFOs in the sense of relating it to enemies in space.
Sure.
But I believe a lot of this stuff probably could be countries like Russia, like China, like others who are, you know, using now drones, using the kind of sophisticated weaponry that, you know, could very well be involved in a lot of these sightings. So I think that's the area to go to, very frankly, in order to identify what's happening.
More importantly, it sounds like you think that you should exhaust that out, exhaust the that hypothesis first before you start dealing with any of the other hypotheses.
Yeah, absolutely. Because, you know, I think the reality is we know what some of these capabilities are from our adversaries. We've seen what they're capable of doing. I think because they are adversaries, it's much more logical to me to believe that they're trying every way possible to be able to gather the kind of intelligence that would help them in terms of developing their approach to how they deal with the United States. I think that's the better approach to take right now.
With regard to strategy, I would never recommend that any military or any citizen ever place all their investigative eggs in one basket. So this interview seems more of an attempt to attenuate public interest in the subject.